Windows Universe. Michael with the Windows Club here. An incorrect time or date in the taskbar can be a headache. In this video, we will look at some possible fixes to the problem. We'll also link an article in the description below that goes more into depth. Now, a word of caution before we get started. It is always a good idea to create a system restore point on your system before making any changes. The first thing we should do is run the system file checker. Open the command prompt with admin privileges and type in /scan now and hit enter. The scanning will take a while, and when it's complete, restart the computer. If that didn't work, then let's look at the date and time settings. In the search bar, type in time to change the date and time. Make sure that the time zone is correct. If it is and the date and time is still incorrect, then toggle the set time automatically from on to off and change the date and the time manually. If the problem has still not corrected itself, then we need to go into the services and correct it there. Type services.msc in the start search and hit enter. In the services pane, navigate down to Windows Time and double click on it. Check and see if the service status is started and typeset it to automatic. Click on apply and click OK, and then exit. It's good to restart your computer at this point and see if the problem has fixed itself then. Control panel. Go to clock and region. Set the date and time. Change the date and time. Update it. Now, then go to internet time and change settings. Usually, by default, your computer is set to time.windows.com, but you can have it set to where it syncs to several other ones. Try and pick one of the others from the drop-down menu, then hit update, OK, and restart it and see if this helps. Now, then we have the option of re-registering the Windows DLL file. DLL files can become corrupted or lost easily, so that might be a concern. Let's open up the command prompt. We run it as an administrator. This, open a command prompt as the administrator and type in REGSVR 32 space W32 time all one word .dll and hit enter. You'll see a dialog box saying that it was registered success. Click on OK and restart your computer. The Windows Time servers maintains the date and time synchronization on all client servers in the network. If the service is stopped, then the date and time synchronization will be unavailable. So if you're having problems with time and date sync, this might be a problem. Let's go back to our command prompt as an admin and type in these commands one at a time. Net stop W32 time W32 TM space unregister, then W32 TM space /register. After that, restart your system and see if the problem has been resolved. Now then you can force the Windows to sync time using W32TM.exe. This is a command line prompt to use to configure, monitor, or troubleshoot the Windows Time service. To do this, let's go back to our command prompt, as always, admin privileges, and type in the following. Net stop W32 time slash unregister W32TM space slash register. Then net start W32 time. And finally, W32 time space slash resync. Restart your computer and see if that has helped. Now, if you're still unable to sync your time and date, there's the possibility that your CMOS battery might have been drained. And to be safe, you should probably replace it. Now, have you experienced a time sync problem? If so, what steps did you take to correct it? Let us know in the comments down below. And for more helpful articles, visit us at thewindowsclub.com. If this video helped, give us a thumbs up and do not forget to subscribe to our channel, where we are always adding new content aimed at making your digital world a little bit easier. Thanks for watching and have a great day.